Hello, my name is Jimmy Costello from the NX product marketing team. Today, we're going to explore variation analysis and how it provides critical insights into the way part-to-part variations and assembly tolerances impact final product quality and functionality. By simulating real-world manufacturing scenarios and analyzing tolerance stackups, we can optimize designs, validate assembly processes, and ensure consistent product quality while maintaining cost-effective manufacturing tolerances. Let's go ahead and get started. We're beginning today with this caster assembly, and our primary focus is going to be understanding our VSA results and how we can take action moving forward. To start, we can open variation analysis from the application tab under the manufacturer group. When this is done, we can find the VSA navigator has been opened on the left-hand side of our screen. Here, we can find a hierarchical tree structure that organizes and manages all the key elements of a variation analysis study. It shows assembly components, including parts, subassemblies, and all associated PMI. Selecting any of these items will highlight the respective part or component within the display window. Additionally, we already have a few measurement operations already created in the navigator. These measurement operations serve multiple essential functions in a VSA test. They define what aspects of the assembly will be evaluated, establish acceptance criteria for the analysis, and provide the basis for statistical calculations and results interpretation. Once we have one of the measurement operations checked in the navigator, we can begin to run our variation analysis tests. The first step in running a test is to select Validate Analysis from the basic group in our home tab. Validate Analysis in VSA performs a preliminary check of our variation simulation setup to ensure all necessary components and parameters are properly defined before running a full analysis. It acts as a diagnostic tool that identifies potential issues or missing elements that could affect the accuracy of our results. After seeing we have no validation errors, we can move ahead and run our simulations. When these simulations finish, there's a few important places to look for results. The first and most obvious location is in the display window. Here we have a summary of the most important statistical values calculated in our simulation. However, if at any time we want a more in-depth and thorough breakdown, we can right-click on our measure operation and select simulation result. This will open a new window containing a deeper dive into the statistics of our results. Inside of this window, the histogram section offers a probability curve based on normalized distributions with the nominal value positioned near center point. Overlying the curve, vertical bar charts highlight the range of measurement values that each section of the curve represents. One other important aspect of the simulation result window is the contributor section found at the bottom. Here we can see how much each component and tolerance impacts the final outcome of our statistical analysis. If we find a value we would like to change, selecting it in the simulation result window will also highlight it within the navigator. This allows us to easily go in, make changes, and reassess how new tolerance values will impact our final design. To redo our simulation with the new values, we begin by validating our analysis, which will now display a warning indicating we're using alternative tolerance values. We can simply select OK, run our simulation, and observe that with our new tolerance value, this component of our design now shows a greatly reduced impact on our overall measurement variance. Taking this a step farther, if we want to update our part tolerancing to reflect our new alternative tolerance, we can go into our navigator, right-click on Process, and select Update PMI. Doing this updates the display in our current assembly window. Additionally, if we open this individual part in a new window, we can see the tolerance has updated there as well. In conclusion, in this video, we've investigated the basics of variation analysis in NX. We started by looking into the basic layout of the application and understanding the navigator. After that, we ran our first simulation and analyzed the results it provided. And finally, we wrapped up by changing tolerances and updating our PMI for our model. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.